Good evening, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you once again for joining me. Back over here, it looks like Daisy is currently going off. I'm going to show you a map of the location of that geyser. Here you go. In the middle here is Daisy Geyser. Up over here is the Old Faithful Lodge. That's where they have the camera posted. Up over here to the top right and to the right, actually through this whole area on the right, that is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Everyone there at the University of Utah probably went home early. The last earthquake they reported happening there at Yellowstone was at 5:38 a.m. Central Daylight Time. It was a magnitude 2.2, they said, but it was actually a magnitude 3.0. Here I downloaded the borehole for the Madison River area, borehole 207. In the center is Maple Creek, and over here is Holmes Hill. Going to Google Earth, here's the location for Maple Creek. This one here is Holmes Hill, and then down over here is the borehole. It's a very deep well, over 600 feet deep, so it doesn't pick up any outside activity. And here at the bottom is the magnitude 2.2. Like I said, it was actually a 3.0. The strongest signature of the three I got is from Maple Creek. There's a spectrogram here for Maple Creek. And you can see down there at the bottom, if you're watching this on your computer or maybe your television, it came in as a magnitude 3.0. And we'll go to the signature. There's the signature as it came in there at Maple Creek. And you can see since this 3.0, there's been several other earthquakes. We got another one marked in red. Let me close this out. And loaded up again. They didn't report that one at 10:40 and 30 seconds universal time. Let me come over here and let's see, where is it? Right there. Go to its signature. It's got a little bit of a P wave on it, and we'll go over here to the borehole. Let's see if it's going to be, yeah, I'm going to have to make it bigger. Okay, right there. That I thought was a really unusual signature. See how it's rounded? I'll make this one bigger for you. Yeah, very unusual. But knowing after I made it larger that it was a tectonic type earthquake because of plate movement, yeah, it started out small and slowly got larger. See the points at the top, how they're sharp? Let me show you something else. Here we have an image of four different types of earthquakes. This was produced by USGS. The top one is tectonic-like earthquakes. That's when the plates move. Shallow volcanic earthquakes. That is when you got magma coming into the system when the system's recharging. And then surface events. Yeah, it starts out small and then slowly grows larger, which that one kind of looks like it did. But it was on three different monitors. That's how I know it's an earthquake. And then we got harmonic tremors. I'll make this bigger for you. Okay. So here I made it larger. Tectonic-like earthquakes. They got the sharp points at the top. Shallow volcanic earthquakes. They have rounded tops. And this is when we got magma coming into a system, recharging a volcano. Surface events start out very quiet and then slowly grow. And then we got harmonic tremors. They have more of a rounded tops and are a little bit smaller. So this is a volcanic tremor. This one they're not reporting. Let's go back over to this one here that I was looking at. See, it doesn't have that long wave in the front. It just, let me make it bigger. And we'll pull it over. Oh, darn it. There we go. I mean, it grew, but not an extremely long P wave on it. And it's got sharpened tops. These are all caused by the movement of the plates. Same with this one that they're not reporting, but does show up on all three monitors. C-sharpened points. Currently, the park is closed. They were supposed to start reopening on the 15th, but I believe that they only have it opened up there by Mammoth Vault. So anyways, we got this one marked. Is that one marked in red? Let me make it bigger. No, it's not marked in red. When it's marked in red, such as this one right here, that one right there, these other two, that means that the computer picked up the earthquake and sends a text message to the geologists, and they're supposed to review it. But evidently, they haven't been in the office since 5 o'clock this morning, or haven't checked their text messages since 5 o'clock this morning. USGS has 14 earthquakes listed for the last 24 hours. These here are Stanley, Idaho. We got one for Lima, Montana. Yeah, supposedly a 0.8 that happened before that. This 2.3 was the largest they've had so far today. So here's the location of that 2.3 for today. We got a 4.0 that they revised to a 3.8. That was on March 11th of this year. And then we got a 2.1. That was last year, January 4th. So let's pull this out a little bit and see exactly where this was. Okay, here we got the Sawtooth Fault Zone. And we also have, which I got drawn out in two different color green lines, that is the Trans Chalice Fault System that goes all the way up to Canada. Yeah, and if Yellowstone ever does have a major eruption, yeah, you guys would be caught in that explosion as well. So down here we have the town of Stanley right there. And then up here is the latest earthquake, the magnitude 2.3. So I haven't done the tilt meter, the uplift or downlift that's going on at Yellowstone in quite a while. This is in millimeters. Up here they're measuring the direction of east. And this one they're measuring the direction of north. And then this one here, let me pull it over so you can see it. I have to pull it over farther. Is when it's all cleaned up, what kind of uplift or downlift they got going on in millimeters. Now it goes all the way, let me pull it down a little bit more. To 2004, we're, maybe 50 millimeters, but they got the red line where they decided that on average where the uplift was going on. And, okay, so you got 40 millimeters there, and I'll show you what it's showing right now. Right there. It was a little bit higher in 2019. But in 2019, yeah, there was all that activity and new springs and new geysers erupting. They either readjusted the machine or they had data missing. And this is what it's currently at. 1, 2, 3, slightly above 3, third line, which is as high as what it was back in 2004. Yeah, Yellowstone goes up and down. And you remember they told us later about how in 2014 there was an earthquake swarm. And looks like the activity has been growing. Uplift has been growing since, probably 2017. Then they readjusted the machine or data missing. And it looks like it's kind of holding steady right now. Might be growing a little bit. Again, this is the monitor, GPS for the Norris Geyser Basin. All right, the next monitor, it looks like it's over by Lake Butte. There's Yellowstone Lake. Over here would be Little West Thumb. And let me bring it down. And we got a lot of data missing, but I'm going to click on this anyways, because you can see here, before 2010, they were gathering GPS data. And, yep, it's higher now. It was higher again. Probably 2017, just after 2016, the uplift started. And right now, it's probably going down maybe a little bit there at Lake Butte. But it's still much higher than when they first started recording the uplift and subsidence of Yellowstone. All right, the next monitor I'm showing you is south of Hedgin Lake, and we'll pull it down. Again, they're measuring east, and they're also measuring north. And you can see we got a steady, slow but steady uplift since they started recording the uplift or deflation of Yellowstone, slowly going up. Just before 2006. And I made it larger for you. Here we got 2018, and they got the red line as average, and you can see it is climbing. All right, so here we have the border of Montana and Wyoming. This is near Gardner, which is also by Mammoth Vault. And we know that the hot spot is slowly moving northeast. So you might find this interesting. Let's come down here. And yeah, look at the uplift that's been going on. Going back to probably 1999. Yeah, and they reset the machine. Oh yeah, that really does some good, don't it? Let me make it bigger. Had steady uplift. Until here by the red line that they got drawn out. Goes up, 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 up. And let me pull it over where they reset the machine. yeah, reset the GPS. What was the date on that? Yeah, this year. Why would they reset it? For all these years. Let me pull it down. This steady increase in uplift. Didn't happen, right? Let me pull this up now. From minus 10 millimeters. And when did they reset it? How high was it? Let's see here. Oh, pretty close to the top, which would have been 30 millimeters. So about 1.2 inches in 20 years. All right, the last one I'm going to show you, I got to do this, is a little bit lower than Gardner, and we'll come down. This one they did not reset, okay? Yeah, they put the machine in the GPS, maybe 2009? There was a lot of activity going on then, and you can follow the red line, reset the machine. Probably 2017 when all that activity was going on. And this is what it's currently showing. The highest uplift, higher than one, yeah, 2010. Yeah, and well, not as high as what it was in 1999. I'll make this bigger. So about 1.2 inches of uplift here. So they haven't fudged with this machine or its settings. And that's this year. You can see it's steadily going up. Yeah, the ground does breathe. It goes up and down, up and down. But it's still going up. So we're still having an earthquake swarm. Not as many as what there was, 2 days ago when I did my report. But it's still reactivating. You can see... Yeah, notice the cliff here where part of it slid off, dropped down. Yep, hot and steamy. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. I'll give you links in the show more information below this video. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.